Wochenend und Sonnenschein und damit dir im Wald allein. Weiter brauch ich nicht zum glücklich sein. Wochenend und Sonnenschein.
Greetings, YouTube misfits, miscreants, malcontents, and misanthropes. Claire's here with her coffee. It's fresh. I think I could pass the smell test. The rest of the show, I'm not so sure about. But come on anyway. We're going to talk about YouTube.
Well, of course, September 11th was and what happened was, of course, a very, very serious thing. And we thought about what can we do to really show the dangers of what happened that day. And we felt burning the Quran would be something of that magnitude.
11 days ago, Jones and his 15 followers held what they called a trial of Islam. They then burned a copy of the Islamic holy book in a barbecue pit near the church altar and posted the video on the internet.
Gosh, how do you suppose Muslims are going to react?
They ignored warning shots from police and stormed the complex, killing four guards, toppling a tower, setting fires, and attacking the UN workers inside. As many as 20 died in the violence. Two of the victims were beheaded. Without a hint of emotion in his voice, Jones told CBS News, "We personally do not feel any responsibility for the carnage in Afghanistan."
Of course Jerry Jones takes no personal responsibility. He's a complete shitwit. He just cares about his 15 minutes of fame. He's your worst nightmare. Trailer trash with a camera in his face. And he couldn't care less if somebody gets hurt or if lots of people die. He wants his 15 minutes of fame. This tells you everything you need to know about fame in this world. You don't need to be smart. You don't need to be talented. You just need to have a big mouth, be a tireless self-promotionist, and be willing to do something outrageous to get on camera. This entire sorry event reminds me I need to name two dim bulbs of the week. A YouTube dim bulb and a sort of world dim bulb. In the past, I've normally picked people as dim bulb of the week, or they're just bozos on YouTube who make a stupid video or say something outrageous. No harm done. We spend a little time poking fun at them and we move on. But people like Terry Jones are on a completely different level. Their words and actions have real-world consequences. They get people hurt and killed. And this week's Dim Bulb of the Week, greater version, is the Reverend Terry Jones.
Oh, palms of victory, crowns of glory, palms of victory.
What else is going on in the world? I just checked the score. It looks like my team, Fulham, is comfortably ahead at the half. They're playing at Craven Cottage today against Blackpool. Unfortunately, I'm still too busy to make any videos lately. I hope that changes soon. Matter of fact, I have to go to work after I finish this video. But I have had a little time to watch some videos, so I want to do some shout-outs. Now, the first is for a couple of young guys named Matt Lewis and Josh Poole, who have produced a couple of videos called The Tudor Parts 1 and 2. That is just hilarious.
I definitely believe the Bible is literally true, just like one-third of my fellow Americans. Some tutors like to give the kids the same stories over and over again, but I like to dig a little deeper and find fresh stories for the children. So, do you guys like stories about bears?
Yay!
I hope you'll tune in for the Tudor's unique perspective on biblical stories for children. My next shout-out today is Ogre Sex, and I intended to shout him out a few weeks ago, and I think I forgot because, well, I was running short of time, as usual. And he has made a video called Angry, which I particularly identify with. More on that later.
I used to be in this relationship. Like all relationships, it had its ups and downs. One particular down was that my partner in this relationship liked to argue.
Sweetheart?
Yes, my love?
Are you okay?
I'm fine.
Okay. Sweetheart, is something wrong?
Nope, got my book, it's a beautiful day, everything's great.
Are you sure?
I am. I am absolutely sure, yes.
Only you seem angry. Are you angry about something?
Oofta, I know where that's leading. I was in a relationship once for about 13 years, and during that time, every couple of months, my partner would ask me if I was angry. Because I hadn't spoken for a couple of hours, well, you see the books back there. I'm kind of a closed-mouth person, and unfortunately, the partner at the time came from a family who, I'm not saying they talked a lot, I'm just saying that a millisecond was a pregnant pause for them. The moral of the story is be careful who you get involved with. Extreme introverts, extreme extroverts, they don't always mix too well, especially if one of them is emotionally needy, needs a great deal of external validation, and is apparently incapable of entertaining themselves for any length of time. Okay, before I go, I believe I promised you a YouTube Dim Bulb of the Week, and I have a couple of nominees today. Of course, it's hard to define the boundary between insane and dim.
Hello, I need to make a statement about what's happening in Japan right now. I have stated on my website that I believe that God has been pouring judgment on Japan.
Not crazy enough for you yet. Keep watching.
When I watched the news coverage, I thought maybe this was just a coincidence, that it just had nothing to do with me. But when I heard that the epicenter was in near Sendai, Japan, which is very close to Hiraizumi, where my Oshu Fujiwara ancestors are from, I knew the Lord sent this earthquake to Japan. Because, you see, I am targeted by the Jesuit Order of the Roman Catholic Church from the day that I was born because of my Catherine the Great and King David genetic profile.
See what I mean? I'll spare you anymore. But let's look at another honey nut cluster.
Okay, today is March 16th, and I'm making this video because I'm trying to warn people who live on the west coast of the United States that I believe there's going to be a major earthquake sometime between now and the 21st of March. This is not a psychic prediction. This is a prediction based on, if you saw my last two videos, saying that I thought something catastrophic was about to happen to the Earth, that I felt that the potential for a major earthquake quake between around the 15th and 19th was there, based partly on the Moon, partly on the Sun, partly on Comet Elenin, and on other factors, including HAARP. Seismic weapons.
It appears that Twig the Sky Dog never met a conspiracy theory she didn't like. She sort of combines a natural explanation, however balmy, with a variety of conspiracy theories, including chemtrails and seismic weapons, to explain the Japan earthquake and the apparently upcoming California earthquake or New Madrid fault earthquake. She was kind of imprecise about where the great disaster is going to strike in the middle of March. Oh, wait a minute, it's April already. Oops. Anyway, it looks like this week's Dim Bulb of the Week award is down to a couple of harmless loons. One's a conspiracy theorist, the other is a religious nut and a conspiracy theorist. Let's go with the religious nut because, as you know, I don't tolerate the God's wrath explanation of natural disasters very well. Congratulations, Gabrielle. You're our Dim Bulb of the Week.
If you want to feel those good vibrations coming from the joy that his love can bring, turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on.
That's all I have time for today. In fact, I'm already late. Bis später.